C'est important pour moi de faire une place au français parce que je suis québécoise et j'ai à cœur de maintenir notre langue vivante. Par contre, c'est sûr qu'il va y avoir pas mal de contenu en anglais ici parce qu'il faut comprendre que les communautés de couture et d'artisanat en général sur Internet sont anglophones. Il y a du monde de partout sur la planète qui se réunit pour échanger là-dessus. L'anglais, c'est la lingua franca d'aujourd'hui. Please pardon my French. Et honnêtement, si vous êtes mad parce que vous entendez une Québécoise faire du contenu en anglais, ben gérez-vous. However, if you're a European francophone and you think my French is funny or has a weird accent or isn't polished enough, please let me cordially invite you to go French yourself. Je rêve souvent que je suis revenue à l'université, tu sais, puis dans mon rêve, on est tout le temps comme j'en passais la mi-session, puis j'ai rien commencé encore. J'ai pas fait mes lectures, j'ai pas fait mes recherches, j'ai même pas décidé qu'est-ce que j'allais faire comme recherche pour mes travaux de session. Puis là, mes remises sont genre la semaine prochaine. Puis là, la nuit passée, j'étais dans mon cours en art et multimédia, l'UQTR. J'avais environ une semaine pour remettre une vidéo de 30 minutes. Sujet libre, dans le fond, c'était pour démontrer qu'on maîtrisait les outils, les caméras, l'éclairage, le son, les logiciels et tout ça. Puis là, dans mon rêve, je me suis mis à me rappeler que j'avais déjà un projet de commencer. J'avais l'idée en arrière de la tête de filmer la confection d'un petit bonnet comme celui que je suis en train de porter présentement, afin d'en faire un tutoriel pour le mettre sur YouTube. Je me suis réveillée pas longtemps après, mais je me souviens m'être sentie super soulagée en me disant « Bon, c'est parfait, je vais pouvoir terminer ce projet-là et m'en servir pour ma remise, mon cours en art et multimédia. » You know, dreams, they're images of your brain. They're pieces of what you've been thinking about during the day. And I've actually been thinking about joining the YouTube sewing community for a long time. There are a lot of wonderful craftspeople out there. I shall name a few in the description box down below. And I've been really envious to see them thrive before my eyes. I think I've been hesitating about doing it for like a full year. But the thing is, putting myself on the internet like that is a really big decision for me because the internet can be a very traumatizing place, you know? Get my drift? So, anyway, here's the positive content. How about getting crafty with me? My name is Sarah Labarre, and for my first video, I thought I'd start with a beginner project, which is why I'm gonna show you how to make this lovely little turban-shaped bonnet, like the one I'm wearing right now. It has a little knot here, it's pleated in the front and in the back. I just thought, you know, it would make a perfect project for a first YouTube video, because it's a beginner project, it's quite simple. I make these bonnets out of breathable non-stretch fabric, like either cotton or linen or silk even. Silk is somewhat less breathable than the other two, but it's the gentlest on the hair. For this bonnet, we're gonna use a 100% cotton print with lovely Brussels sprouts. It's just too gosh darn cute! Look at these little Brussels sprouts! But before we begin, let me apologize in advance if I'm confusing some of you by using both the imperial and metric systems. I'm sorry. I think this is a Canadian thing. I think. I don't know. Do you also use both imperial and metric systems? Let me know in the comments. I'm genuinely curious to know about this. So let's start! So, you're gonna wanna take your tape and measure around the largest part of your head. And also, you want to measure at a few angles. You know, take a few measurements. And you're gonna want to take the largest of all these measurements. You know, measure your head at least like, no kidding, 5 times. You can get away with a little too loose, but you don't want a hat that's too tight. My measurement is 23 inches. It's quite on the larger size. It actually makes it real hard for me to find a hat that fits in the stores. Your head circumference is probably gonna be maybe a tad smaller, and it's Okay.
All right, our next order of business is to draft our hat pattern. There is a bit of math involved. Please note that there is going to be a picture of this on my Instagram. I'm gonna put the link down in the description box. To draft our turban pattern, we're gonna need a rectangle of fabric that's folded at the top. To measure the width of a rectangle, we need to divide our head measurement by 2. Then we add a half inch of seam allowance on each side, here and here. And then we add about 3/4 inch of ease. If you're using bulky fabric or if you plan on putting a lining in your hat, I suggest putting more ease in that, perhaps a fat inch or even more. My measurement for my hat pattern is 13 inches and a quarter. For the height of my pattern, there's really no math involved, I just winged it. If you have bulky hair like I do, you're gonna want a rectangle that's at least 16 inches high. That includes seam allowance, but if you have little to no hair, I suggest you cut it a little shorter. Although, I wouldn't go shorter than, say, 14 inches because the added height allows you to make those pleats. It does get tucked away.
Alright, now we have our fabric square. It's 13 1/4 inches wide and it's 16 inches high. And because I want to make a few hats at a time and I need to work fast, and because I do not own a serger, I abhor them, I'm going to sew my front and back seams with a French seam. Which means I have to start with the wrong sides facing each other and the right sides facing out. So let's sew the front seam first. I'm not gonna sew all the way from the top down. Instead, we need to leave about 1.5 inches from the top, backstitch a bit, and then sew all the way down with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. This is so we end up with a small opening at the top front of our hat. There is no need to measure anything, you can just wing it. And we're sewing the back seam all the way from the top to the bottom with a 1/4 inch seam allowance as well. Our next order of business is to trim our seam allowances to about 1/8 inch, making sure you leave the opening at the top intact because we're gonna roll that down later. We can then flip our hat over and we are going to start rolling the seam between our fingers, like so, until they're both really perfectly flat together. Pin it to secure it, move on to the next section until both sides of our hat are completely flat together. We're gonna finish our French seam by sewing them again with a 1/4 inch seam allowance, starting with the front seam and making sure you're not forgetting to leave your opening intact. The next step is to finish the bottom hem of our hat. You can do that by machine, but I personally do not like to see a machine seam when I can avoid it, because for me it just looks neater to do it by hand. So I'm pressing a 1/4 inch towards the wrong side of the fabric right now. Your French seams are gonna want to sit on either side. Make sure they're both leaning towards the same side. Thank you. Then you're gonna take a needle and some thread, and you're gonna stitch your hem down with a regular and steady whip stitch. Okay, so I have no idea where that footage went, but I rolled down the seam allowance on the top hole in the front. I rolled it down twice and I whip stitched it in place to finish it. Let's make our front pleat now. I'm putting a horizontal pin every 5 centimeters from the edge, like so. If you opted for a shorter hat, you might want to put the pins closer to each other, or make fewer pins. It's really all up to you. You are then going to want to pinch the fabric along the first pin and tuck it upwards so it lays, say, about 0.5 centimeter or 1/4 inch away from the next pin. I'm using another pin to secure it in place, and you're going to want to do this to every pin until you've reached the hole at the top. For your last pleat, you're simply going to make sure that it lies right under the hole at the top of our hat. Don't pin the top hole anywhere, we're gonna leave this alone for now because this is where we're gonna pass our little bow thingy through. For the back pleats, I'm still putting in a horizontal pin every 5 centimeters. And like I did with the front, I'm pinching every pin, folding it and tucking it upwards, but this time around 1/2 inch or so from the next pin because the back of your head needs more space than the front. And like with the front, I'm gonna pin all the way to the top until there's no space for pleats anymore. Next thing you're gonna want to do is tuck the little pointy end inside and pin everything into place. Now take a look at the bottom edge of your back seam. Fold it inwards by about 0.5 inch and pin it in place. Now is an excellent time to try out your hat and play around with it to make sure that you like the shape and the fit before you actually commit to sewing your pleats together. Of course, you can sew your pleats together with the machine, but that leaves a visible seam, which I do not like, so I'm gonna sew them by hand, making sure that my stitches are as discreet as possible. As you can see, I'm only stitching around where the bulky French seam is. I'm not gonna stitch anywhere else. Make sure you don't forget to stitch down the bottom edge of that back seam. The last step in our hat making endeavor is to make the little bow thingy at the front top of our hat. For this, we're gonna need a 5-inch by 5-inch square of fabric that we're gonna fold into right sides facing each other, and that we're gonna sew with a 1/2 inch seam allowance. Back at the ironing board, we're gonna flip the little tube over, give it a good press, and we're gonna end up with a strap that's about 2 inches wide. Next, you're gonna need to push this tube through the top opening of your hat, making sure you're hiding your seam and that you're pushing or tucking the pointy end towards the front of the hat, like so. Then you're gonna need to fold the bottom front edge inwards and wrap the tube around it. going inside the hat, you're gonna fold the raw edge under like so and pin everything into place. All it needs now is a few hand stitches to make sure it stays secure like this, and your hat is complete! And there's the complete hat! I'm very happy with the result. It's easy to put on and to take off. There's enough room for my giantess head. And the best thing is, I can match it with masks from the leftover fabric that I had. I'd like to take this moment to thank everyone for watching and for bearing with my very beginner YouTubing skills. It seems like everything I learned in art school has long been forgotten, but it's okay. We're all here to help each other learn, and I'm so very happy to just being a part of it. Please check out my Instagram if you want to take a look at all sorts of crafts I've been doing in my homestead, sewing of course, but also painting, felling trees and building raised garden beds out of them, and even building my own smokehouse. Please subscribe to this channel for more crafty time with me, and comment down below if there's any crafty content / tutorial you'd like to watch next. Thank you, bye!
Dans mes rêves, on est... Oh, God, it's...